Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Time Princess on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5, that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. It packs a punch with mega performance upgrades and it has faster performance than any other high-end Android device or Android platform. We will be able to easily download and install Time Princess and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5. Which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Time Princess. So without further ado, let's get to it. First of all buddies, to get started we have to launch our main browser. We open the one we prefer. Let's go to the current URL that I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you are able to discover on the PC screen. You don't need to type it, simply because I added a clickable link in the description of this video and as well in the first pinned comment. We landed there on our website of Usitility, at which we find here a precise demonstration on how to obtain Time Princess on personal computer. We scroll lower a bit and just click on the Download Game on PC button. After clicking on this link, we land here on the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to run to play Time Princess on PC. It is now obvious that we access a number of pros of preferring that emulator. Now we are ready to proceed to download the Time Princess by clicking on this button play on BlueStacks that you can see here in green color. The step is clicking on this button. And the download step starts and ends immediately. Here it is. Here is located the download. It is an executable file. The following step is to launch the installer, so we have to click on this file. If we are on Windows 10 it will have asked us for permission to allow changes to the computer. We clicked yes. I minimize the internet browser to see the installer considerably better. The installer is uncomplicated. It consists of two possibilities, install and setup path. I will show you what setup path genuinely does. We simply click it, and we note that we have here the path where your emulator can be set up. If we choose to change for better this directory we have to click on this browse option, and we decide on another folder and set up the emulator specifically where we would like. To keep it simple, just set it by default. I simply click on back. And I just click install. Now, there it is. The setup starts and it's going to progress in the download of those MB that are represented on this computer screen. When you download it, it is likely to be slightly more or less MB. The download speed may go at a higher speed or slower, subject to your connection and according to the speed of the emulator hosting servers. Right now they're progressing really fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. Now, the emulator happens to be launched immediately. As you can see, at the bottom of the screen, there is a progress bar that will move forward to the right and once it attains the ending, the emulator will be started for the very first time. In fact, the emulator has been launched, here for the very first time. Before we continue, as you will notice, it has created two app icons there on the computer desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks app icon is the one we're concerned with. Whenever we need to launch Time Princess on the laptop or computer, we double-click on that icon and consequently use the emulator. The BlueStacks multi-instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved multi-instance manager in Eco mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. Let's conduct the next step, that is a must-have. And this is to log on to the Google Play Store. And we will just click on Play Store. As you can see the Google Play is started. Here we must log on. At this moment once we are there, we must definitely execute this next phase which is compulsory. So that we mouse click on, sign in. Now it shows, checking info. It can in some cases get stopped at, checking info. That's why it isn't going to continue. If so, you may try to log in after a number of hours it's going to quite likely be sorted out. Now we're going to enter our email and password. The email address ought to be a Gmail email and its matching password. For instance, you can utilize the same email you're using at this moment in your own YouTube account. So I am going to submit my information and I'll revisit immediately after I have done it. That's it, info entered. And here is Google welcoming us and presenting us their twos. We must accept all of them by simply clicking, I agree. Next, it make us possible to back up to the Google Cloud. You could keep it selected, it's going to generate a backup of your files on that device to Google Drive. I am not going to select it, you can use that option if you wish. We just click on accept. Google Play is started by default and immediately. To set up the application, we have got to get to the emulator desktop by simply clicking that app icon marked green colored. Now that we are discovering the desktop of the Android emulator, we can see that we find right here the install app game button. We simply click on that button. Here we have got the game. Let's quickly mouse click now on the install link that I'm just highlighting now in green color. And it will commence the installation. At present it is going to install the Android game. It may take a little while or perhaps it could also be very fast. It again all is dependent upon on our own internet access. It has already ended installing. Now, let's go to the emulator desktop by clicking this button I'm emphasizing in green, so that you can use Time Princess for the first time. We are currently on the emulator desktop, then we're on the way to just click that fresh Time Princess icon which has been generated. The game app is launched for the first time, so there we end up with it. I could mouse click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I will discuss the volume of this emulator. This is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume along with the icon of lower volume. This way we are not going to count on the Microsoft Windows volume to increase or decrease the audio of your emulator. And to take pleasure in the experience to the fullest, we could activate the large monitor, for which we have two alternatives. This is actually the first one. We mouse click on that app icon which I am basically pointing out in green color. And the monitor is maximized, having one border on top, one on the right side and the third one at the bottom. In case we need to enjoy the video game using all the screen, we mouse click on this particular software icon. And we might already be experiencing the Android game in 100% screen setting. To stop the full screen setting, click the F11 key. And we'd already end up being in standard display screen setting. Now I am choosing to show you the computer keyboard mapping and that is certainly quite cool. This strategy we will likely be ready to use the game application a lot more effortlessly. The first thing is to click on this software icon. It's now time to make the required controls. I'll go ahead and put the normal configuration. However, if you choose to improve it, you may well do so without having problem. Perhaps you have realized, the emulator is entirely in our language. Occasionally it occurs that your emulator is started in the erroneous language, for example, in Japanese. And consequently to place it in the right language we click here to the cogwheel. And there within additional controls, we just click the language drop down. We should go with the language we want. Italian, Japanese, and so forth. Once the language is determined, we could save, the emulator will reboot, and the game, next time we run it, will as well be in the specified language. Now, you can find another detail that we will need to take into consideration, and this is that we will get a message from Google saying that a brand new equipment has been connected with our Google account. It will definitely check with us if we're the individuals who have connected that device. Yup, we shouldn't get worried, considering that the emulator is behaving like an Android tablet or smartphone. And to find which device is being emulated, we come back right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. And we browse here to the model option. And right here we realize that the emulator is simulating a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. That's all guys, so much for the training. I sincerely hope you appreciated it, specifically that everyone found it handy. In this case, bring it a good thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and any feedback, questions or suggestions, put them in the comment box down below. You can even leave comments on my Twitch channel. I do live streams ever so often. You get it listed below in the video description and in the initial pinned comment. Simply click on any of those videos that are appearing on the computer screen and let's have fun again in the next videos. Bye.